Students, we'll move on with the next topic, that is numeric operators. So in Ruby, the numeric operators, what we are seeing is similar to that what we've already seen in our C language. So here we begin with the binary operators. So binary operators are nothing but these are the operators which take two operands. So here the binary operator we have is plus, minus, multiplication, division, exponential represented by double asterisk. And you have modulus, which is represented by the percentage symbol. So the difference between the division and modulus is division is going to give you the quotient value, whereas modulus is going to give you the remainder as the answer. Okay, so we'll just see with an example. So I will start, or I'll invoke the interactive Ruby. So the command I'm giving is IRB. So the interactive Ruby will be invoked here. So in the interactive Ruby, it is possible for us to give any expression and get the result immediately. So I'll give 3 plus 2. So I got answer as 5. 3 minus 2, 1. 3 star 2, we have 6. Some 6 divided by 2, I got the answer as 3. That's nothing but the quotient value. Similarly, 6 mod 2, if I'm giving, then I'm going to get the remainder. So that's the difference between quotient and remainder. So divide is going to give you the quotient value and mod is going to give you the remainder value. Other than this, 3 double asterisk 2, that's nothing but 3 raised to 2. It is going to give you the answer as 9. Then some other example we can will just see, like something like 13 divided by 4. So I'm getting an answer as 3. I should get something 3 point something. So to what happens in Ruby is, since both the values what I've given is an integer, so I'm going to get a result in terms of a integer value. So if I want to get it in float, then I'll give 13.0 divided by 4.0. If I'm giving, then I'm going to get 3.25. okay. Other than this, we'll just show you example using variables. So I'll have a variable A and I'll give some value as 10. Okay, so what happened now? The assigning of value to a variable is similar to what we have seen in our C language by using this assignment operator. So we have assigned a value 10 to A. Okay, now I'll do A plus 2. So what happens? A is assigned a value 10, and when I'm giving plus 2, so the 10 value will be considered. So 10 plus 2, you're going to get answer as 12. So this is about your binary operators. Okay, so next we'll go to precedence and associativity. So all this concept we've already learned in our C language. So just recall of this. So precedence operator specifies which operator is to be evaluated first when two operators that have different levels of precedence appear in an expression. Just we'll take an example. So 3, I'll give plus 2 into 2 minus 1. So what happens here? We have an expression and we have operators which are of different precedence level. So according to this, star is having a higher precedence value. That is, multiplication is having a higher precedence value than addition and subtraction. So precedence is nothing but it is telling us which operator should be evaluated first. So according to this, which should be evaluated? 2 into 2 should be evaluated. So 2 into 2, 4, and this will be going. So that there comes the picture of associativity. So associativity will tell us whether you have to move from left to right or you have to move from right to left. So since you are having operators like plus, multiplication and minus, we are going from left to right. So what happens here? So first multiplication is done, that is 2 into 2, 4 plus 3, then you have minus 1. So you'll be getting answer as 6. 4 plus 3, that is 7. 7 minus 1 is 6. Okay, so that is about your precedence. So associativity specifies which operator is to be evaluated first when two operators with same precedence level appear in an expression separated only by an operand. So associativity, precedence, what did we say? we have operators which are of different precedence. In such cases, which operator should be evaluated first? Whereas associativity, we might be having operators which are of same precedence level. In such cases, which one should be evaluated? Whether you're going from left to right or whether you're going from right to left, that has been told by this associativity. According to that, if you're having operators multiplication, division, mod, binary add as well as subtraction, then you're going from left to right. If you're having exponential or you have unary addition and subtraction, then you're coming from right to left. Okay, so that is about your binary operators and precedence and associativity. Next, we'll come to math module. So in a C language, if you want to use some built-in mathematical function, just take an example of square root, then we are going to write a statement, right? So as hash include math.h. So why are we using that? Why are we writing that? Because we want to use a mathematical function in our program. So similarly, here also we have math module, which has methods for basic trigonometric as well as transcendental function. Just show you with an example. I'll write put as, I want to find square root of a number. So I'll write SQRT, that is to find the square root of 25. So I'll give 25. So whenever you're using this functions, like in this case I've used square root, it should be preceded by math. Okay, it should be preceded like this. So you can just see I have a result as 5.0. So what happens, this particular function is going to take a numeric type of parameter and it is going to give you a result in terms of float value. Okay, so this is about your math module. Next, we'll come to interactive Ruby. So we have already worked in interactive Ruby. Okay, so whatever we are working now, this is your interactive Ruby. So interactive Ruby allows one to type any Ruby expression and get the immediate response from the interpreter. Yes, we type 3 plus 2, we got immediate answer here, right? So interactive Ruby allows us to type any Ruby expression and get the result immediately. The acronym or this interactive Ruby is represented by the command IRB. Okay, so when you give IRB, you are going to interactive Ruby is going to give me a prompt. So this is a prompt which your interactive Ruby has given us. Okay, so that is what IRB, when you give IRB, the prompt is displayed. Okay, so you can see here one example. So we already done some examples here. So the result is shown like this. Okay, so you can see here the default prompt here. So this is your default prompt, right? So if you want to change that prompt, then we can change that prompt by using this config prompt underscore I equal to, now I want to change the prompt to this double angular brackets. Okay, so I'll give config dot prompt I, so that is used to change the prompt. So your prompt has been changed to this. Okay, so suppose if I'm giving A is equal to 5, then you can see the prompt has been changed, right? So A plus 2 if I'm giving, so you can see this is a prompt. So your prompt has been changed to double angular bracket. So previously what was your prompt? This was your prompt. But now you can see it has been changed to this double angular bracket. Okay, so previously just see here, everywhere we had this prompt. But now you just have double angular bracket. Okay, so that is about your interactive Ruby. Yes. So we are done with the numeric operators as well as interactive Ruby. I hope you have understood this. Thank you.